Hello and welcome to this week's edition of the Digital and Social Media News for leaders of nonprofits, churches and faith-based organizations. I'm Natchi Lazarus, and this week we have news about Apple, Instagram, Facebook, Google and a very interesting research report which talks about typing whatever you think in your brain. This is a research conducted by University of California, San Francisco and funded by Facebook, which is aiming to create a program called Brain Computer Interface. So stay tuned for that. This is the show where we bring you the top 5 news you need to know for this week in less than 5 minutes. Let's get started. The first big news of this week is from Apple. Apple confirmed its plan last week to release its own credit card called the Apple Card. Apple Card will start accepting applications from August. To start with, it will be rolled out in the US, and this will not be your regular credit card with the 16-digit number and CVV, the stuff that we are used to. According to the company, they will generate a card number randomly for every purchase to make it more secure. Interesting, isn't it? So it'll be exciting to see how this pans out for Apple, but it's definitely starting a big trend in the tech industry where technology companies are getting into credit card business. Our next news is about Instagram. Instagram announced last week that you will be able to schedule your Instagram posts and your IGTV posts on your desktop using Facebook's Creator Studio tool. So if you're already using Creator Studio, you know that there are lots of options for managing a Facebook page. And now you will be able to connect your Instagram account and start scheduling Instagram posts right from your desktop. So this can be really helpful for ministries and nonprofits who have teams managing Instagram. Instead of using your mobile, you now can do it on your desktop. Our next news is from Google. Google announced last week that there is a new update to their Featured Snippets section of the search engine. Featured snippet is basically that extra information that you will see once you search for something on Google. For example, let's say you're searching for World Cup, and you will see, instead of just defining what World Cup is or about World Cup, it will give you the schedules of the matches and, you know, the scores of the different teams so far and so on. Have you seen that? That is called featured snippets. Now Google is saying they have updated that so that the system knows whether the result is outdated or is it current and relevant. So basically what you need to understand in this news is Google is getting smarter about the age of the content, and it is getting smarter about which content they need to show and which content they need not present to people. So you as a creator, as a leader, when you think of it, create content that is clearly laid out. You know, when Google searches or browses through your content, Google's algorithm should know this is how your data is structured, your information is structured, so that it can present it in the most relevant format to people. Our next big news is about a research report on brain-computer interface program. This is a program that will basically help you type with your brain, not your fingers. Whatever you think, you will be able to type. Now, this is a breakthrough technology, and researchers at University of California, San Francisco have released their findings. And this is a program that was sponsored by Facebook. So the details of the findings are also available on Facebook's blog and the university's blog and also on nature.com. I will link to all the three stories. This is really interesting. Go through it. Even though this technology is at a very nascent stage, it's just getting started, but these reports indicate that they have made good progress. So it is only a matter of time before it actually becomes a practical thing and we start seeing this being implemented on our day-to-day devices and all that we do on technology. Before we look at the last piece of news, I want to encourage you to take the time to subscribe and follow us wherever you're watching this so that you do not miss another episode. If you want this news to be delivered on your WhatsApp, you can just visit natchi.net/WhatsApp and we will send it to you every week. Thank you. Let's move on. Our final news of this week is from Facebook. Facebook has confirmed that it is planning to add the word from Facebook to Instagram and WhatsApp in the app stores. So Instagram will be renamed as Instagram from Facebook and WhatsApp as WhatsApp from Facebook. So the company has said that it is to make clear that these products and services are from Facebook. But what I want you to notice is how Facebook is bringing together all these three platforms. Many people don't even know that Instagram and WhatsApp are from Facebook, but they will know that very clearly soon. But operationally, if you think of it, these three are going to be interoperable, and the company has been hinting that, they've been stating that very clearly, and very soon you will be able to operate on all these three platforms simultaneously with a lot of ease. So start planning for that. If you are using one platform and not the other, then maybe you want to think how you're going to use your content on all these platforms when Facebook makes the interoperability very convenient very soon. Well, that's all I have for you this week. Thank you for joining me. If you'd like to dig deeper into any of the stories, we've got all the source links and transcripts in our news page, natchi.net/news. Please share this with other leaders of nonprofits, churches, ministries. I really appreciate it. I will see you next week with another set of news items. Until then, stay connected, stay blessed. God bless you. Bye-bye.